Did you know Project Charter can help you get from 5 to 6 questions? Understanding a project charter is very, very important. Hello friends, today I am recording a quick video on project charter by making a mind map. A mind map will help you understand what is there in a project charter and retain it for a longer time. Let's get started off. First thing, a project charter is a formal document. Formal document because it authorizes the initiation of the project. A project charter is an internal document. And when you create a project charter, always remember there is no cost associated by creating a project charter because there is no dollar value. A project charter assigns a project manager. Now this person is a multitasking person, so with so many things to do, remember that a project charter helps a project manager in allocating resources like workstations, cubicles, laptops, desktops, project travel, cab, somebody's doing overnight or working late. So all these things are important. Now, the project charter comes within the boundary of the project. A project charter is not external to the project. It is internal. This document is an internal document. There are external documents like agreements, business case, business needs, benefits management plan. These things are external to the project, but a project charter is internal document. Very important. Please remember, a project charter cannot change throughout the course of the project. Like on the first day of the project, the project charter looked like this. Let's say a simple triangle. After 100 days, it will still look the same. If there is a change to project charter, then you have to have a change request and get the cost for that. So charter doesn't change throughout the course of the project. Any changes to the charter will impact the change to baseline. Probably the project might also change. Okay. Now, who authorizes the project charter? It is the project sponsor. Let's come to this. So what all does a project charter contain? A project charter contains high level information on what are the constraints. What are the risks involved? What are the milestones? What is the scope of the work? Who is the PM? Who is the sponsor? Who are the POCs? What is the entry and exit criteria? So all this information is present in the project charter, and this helps to manage, to make the project management plans. Therefore, this becomes input to the project plans. More importantly, a project charter is a link between the organizational strategy and the project. All the projects should align with the org strategy. Last but not the least, the purpose of the project charter is defined in the project charter. Why is the project done is defined in the project charter. So friends, the inputs given in this mind map will help you understand many basic concepts for your PMP examination. I wish you all the best. If you like the video, please do drop a note in the comment section. Have a nice day. This is Arham Faraaz.